It will take about 2 weeks from start to finish. We will pass through towns such as Campbell River, Port Hardy, Bella Bella, Prince Rupert, Ketchikan, Wrangell, Petersburg, Juneau, Glacier Bay, and then our final destination, Skagway, Alaska, which is the top of the Southeast Panhandle. To me, it's like riding a motorcycle. I was seriously considering getting back into riding a motorcycle, a full-dress motorcycle on the roads. This is a 1,000-mile road with not one stoplight or stop sign on it.
He came up with the idea of riding PWCs from Vancouver to Alaska for a couple of reasons. One's pretty exciting. Two, it's never been done before. And three, what a great adventure.
I'm not a boater from way back like Dan, so I'm coming at it fresh, and I like how easy it is. It gives you a sense of freedom. You are right there. You know, you're right there on the ocean. You can get out there, and sometimes what we like to do is we get out in wide open spaces and just shut the engine off and just sit there and rock.
I've always wanted to go to Alaska, and I guess that's really one of the ways Dan convinced me was, let's go to Alaska and see it from a different point of view.
We were told you cannot take a personal watercraft to Alaska, and that's what motivated us to make sure it could get here. Unsupported, with no support vessels, everything self-contained on the craft.
Fuel range was a major concern of ours. The way they come, generally, they have about a 70-mile range or something like that. And that wasn't even close to what we had to do. We have a couple of legs that are in the 140-mile range. So we had to put on additional tanks.
What I ended up doing on the tanks was I ended up finally adapting a tank that was originally designed for dune buggies, actually. And we sort of marinized them. We took off the automotive filler necks and cut them out, put on new filler necks that had watertight sealed. It was also a bottom feeder tank. We made it a top feeder tank to comply with the US and Canadian Coast Guard regulations. And then worked on mounting it on the system and onto the machine, and it took about 3 months to get that worked out, and it worked very well.
We eased into it. We started to get books and read books and the charts and study the water and, you know, talk to people and find out when was the best time to go and the best places to see. And just every place that we've gone, it's something new. You arrive finally after a hard day's riding, and you're there, and it's a new place to see and experience. And we've stayed in the whole range, from ghost towns to really beautiful lodges, and sleeping on somebody's kitchen table because they decided to take mercy on us, to having it all done for us. So it's been, the whole thing's wonderful. You can't really pinpoint one specific. It's great.
We haven't run into as much flat water as we would like to. We've had some bumpy rides, and then you get a nice flat patch like we had today, and then you can just cruise and look, and you see things that are just awesome. They just are beautiful, and it's well worth the trip. It's worth it.
I find that when I travel on other boats, we tend to travel in more of a direct, straight line route. But with the personal watercraft, we find that if we see something really interesting, we just turn around and zip over there real fast and take a look. So. We get to see a lot more, and we can hug the coastline a little bit, and that's kind of exciting. The waterfalls are always great.
You feel like the eagles that you see, the animals, like you're just at home in a world of your own.
You got to try it. I mean, you got to do these things. This is an incredible adventure. We're seeing parts of the country that people just don't see. We've been into places that I've only heard of and read of, and I mean, this is a wonderful adventure.
It's never a dull moment.
Wait till next year. Even though it's been pretty nasty water and it's been raining most of the time, you get a place like this where it's beautiful and calm and quiet. I mean, you can't beat it. We're on top of the world. Almost, actually. In about a week we will be.